Welcome, everyone. Welcome to another lovely episode of the Wahaala Boys podcast.
This is you forgot you're on podcast now.
Well, I just got cut off again, people. All right, this time I'm not going to go into it and then do my intro. I'm going to do my intro at the very beginning. So I'm going to start all over again. Otherwise, Nana call me like you. Oh, no, already you interrupt me again. I don't know what's happening to him right now. Welcome, everyone. Welcome to another lovely episode of the Wahaala Boys podcast. This is the Wahaala Boys. Speaking to you right now is Mr. Nobody. And yeah, the guy that just really interrupted me, my intro, is Nana Kwame. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's going to be, I did it one of the last times.
And yeah, how many times are you doing
Nana
this?
And I was like, how do you know the show was going to be lovely? Well, I would think it would be a lovely episode. Okay. I would think it would be a lovely episode. Thank you for joining us. This is going to be another, this is definitely another episode that we're doing here at the Wahaala Boys Center.
Why are you waffling anyway?
I'm not. I'm just basically trying to. I'm very clear. I'm just.
You're waffling.
I'm not.
Every day he's waffling.
You know what?
Every day he's waffling, 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 waffling.
Yeah. Let Rickross find out. You're remixing the song without letting him know. Are you going to hear her?
Nah, he's a skinny dude. Nah, I can take him on anyway.
All right. You will know he have his fart stored away somewhere. You could just throw it on whenever you think there's trouble. All right, so what's going on?
Oh, Lord. What were you discussing? Actually, before we start, right, have you heard, like, what's it called? Two Barbers in a song with Burna Boy?
No, but I can bring it up if you want me to.
That's dope, man. It's actually dope, too.
Is it? Let's check it out.
It's actually
When was it released?
Just yesterday. Oh, well, the YouTube video was released yesterday.
Oh, yeah. Is it Two-Face? Is he dropping a new album?
It probably. Well, not this. What's the point in dropping an album, man? You better doing singles. Moving on.
I don't even think Afrobeat artists really focus on albums. They focus on singles.
They used to, but the point is, what's the point?
I mean, if they have 22 songs in it in an album, I can guarantee you they're probably donating videos for it. It's not a normal conventional way of release an album, do two tracks. I'm sorry, do two singles, release. It's like every song in there could be a single. That's how good these guys are.
But the point is, what's the value in actually doing an album? Especially in a place that nobody buys an album. There's no value in it.
They do buy an album.
Get a shit out of it.
Nobody's buying an album.
As a matter of fact, look, those days that anybody was buying an album,
when it was cassette players. Do you think we Africans buy records?
We used to. When it was cassettes, we used to.
That's
And even when it moved to what's it called, CDs, we bought a couple.
Bought a couple?
Yeah. But after that.
No, but I remember P Square or was it the band that was selling millions of records in
but that's what I said. Those are those days.
Well, we don't have those days anymore.
Nah, bruh.
But maybe it's because of the way artists now, like your Davidos and your Wizkid, the way they actually making records and releasing records, like your Tiwa Savage and stuff. Because they release records now. I mean, YouTube is that main source of places to go. YouTube, Spotify, and all the other iTunes. So they don't the way music has been consumed generally is different now, right? Well, it's so different that, and plus we're Africans, right? Like most Africans don't really worry about planning for an album. They're going to the studio, they make a song, it looks good, they're releasing it.
No, because that became a new thing now. Because those days, there was a natural, as a matter of fact, before a single came out, most people had their albums. Right. And then they release the single and then, they try to push with it. The point is, it got to a point where it wasn't making money. Because think about it this way. Think about it this way. Those days, you had your album out.
Yeah.
The official album, let's say you put 10,000 out. The unofficial is probably, 40,000.
But we have an issue of piracy.
But that's the point I'm trying.
So why would you focus on an album?
No, but still.
I release an album where you sold 1 million... But unofficially,
on the street,
you sold 50 million. Okay, like officially, you sold one, but unofficially, you sold 50. And then the 49 million money in that, you don't see none of it. And then the 1 million that you sold money from, it's probably like you only sold 20% of that because all record label, all the other stuff. And this. So, it makes sense. And plus, in Nigeria and Ghana and places that we're talking about, artists don't make money on records. They make money on shows.
No, before that's what I'm
saying. They make money on shows.
No, before they were making look, before they were making tons of money on...
What was the outlet? They didn't have any outlet.
No, like...
They didn't have a record store.
They did!
No, they didn't. It was market. It was street corner.
No, but the street the street corner guy, like in Ghana, again, I can only talk about the place I come from. In Ghana, this is how it worked, right? We had these places like Pat Thomas had one and all these other places. So you go there, you buy the... So the street guys would go there and buy these cassettes.
Yeah.
Right, so they buy like, I don't know, 500 or 200 or whatever it is, and they come on the street and sell it.
That's what I'm saying. That's
and when it goes off, then you go buy a new one. So when you want your money, you go to the wholesale people, and that's what artists used to do. So they'll turn up every week and go claim money.
But that was make sustainable. Because a lot that can go wrong. The guy can say, I didn't sell, whatever can happen.
No, because you know how much you put on the street. So now you are making a lot of money, even though people are putting all the other fake ones on top. But even with the fake ones, and that's what I'm saying, even with the fake one in the system, artists were making ridiculous amount of money. This is how bad it is.
They could have been making a lot more for their work.
Oh, no, we're talking about sustainability.
But I think right now, what they've done right now is most of the revenue comes to them. Because if you put your song out on YouTube, that channel makes the money. Put your song out on iTunes.
Yeah, but that's assuming people don't jack it anyway. Because like on YouTube now.
Yeah, but you can block people on YouTube.
Yeah, but then how many of them are
watching? Yeah, but you can.
But
my point is, if you were on the market area, you really can't control how many people duplicate your record. But on YouTube, you can.
Yeah, like one of the
on iTunes, you can.
One of the artists in Ghana, Ofriam Ponsa, it was like he met some guy, right? And the guy was like, his record put him through uni.
Nice. But that's bad for him. Good for the guy. Because, come on, I mean, you can't be mad at that. But you can't be mad at that.
No, because it got to a point, this guy was churning out music.
No, but you can't be mad at that.
Every year he was on top with his music. And then he said he was going to be a pastor.
It means you're hot cake at that point.
Oh, no, he was. For like 5 years, he dominated.
Let's listen to the YouTube, to the Two Face and Burna
Boy. What do you mean? You can't even pronounce Two Baba's name. Have you seen, and you look at the video.
It's supposed to be like, what? This is a single?
Yeah, it's a single.
Like, this is not going to go far.
I love the song.
What would you love about the song? Maybe it's because it's new, the message is sound.
Of course, trying to listen to, and it's a proper 2 hour song.
We must group. That's the note.
Yeah.
Let's try and see what Burna Boy is.
Somebody listens to this guy, it's gonna sound really choppy, you know.
Yeah, which is supposed to happen. Like, people come down to listen to it.
Alright, I think this is wrong.
What? I think this is a summer track, and they just released it. Oh, it's summer anyway, everywhere in Africa. So. It's somewhere everywhere in Africa. But this is somewhere track. It looks like, I mean, yeah, it's called We Must Groove. So
yeah,
the track, it's like it's, you're cruising.
Look,
this,
I love
this is a record for when you have like a car that's a converted car where you can turn pull down the roof, play this. I don't know if you could do that.
Since yesterday, I've been charming to this thing anyway.
Well, it's already racked up about 200,000 views.
I was gonna say mine is half of it, but that's not true. Point is, I think it's a dope song. But in the video, looking at Burna Boy. Burna Boy looks more like an American rapper than an Afrobeat artist.
That's his brand. That's the way he wanted to present himself.
Whichever way it is, Nate is a guy that claims he's, you know, he's the Afrobeat king. Meanwhile, he looks nothing like an Afrobeat artist.
How does Afrobeat artist look? Because like now you're talking about looks now. How does an Afrobeat artist look?
I look at Tupac in that video,
Just an old man.
No, Tupac don't look, as a matter of fact, I was like, Tupac looks the same as, you know, African Queen to me anyway from that video.
The guy refused to get old. He's been old for a long time. That's what that is. He's been old for a long time. So he refused to get old. Look, or he refused to get older. But
when you watch the video, right? Listen, Burna Boy, looks like Tuba Ba is featuring an American rapper.
Burna Boy, let me tell you something. Burna Boy's got money now. Okay, like
that's not about
it's
the
full
money.
Of life now. Like his muscles are all coming out. He's got money to do his hair. Like he's got money to wear his specs. Like. But I'm always,
why is that going to do money?
Boy.
We're not talking about
boy.
Money.
He's
we're talking about
him.
Image. And if I look at the image of Burna Boy,
it doesn't look American either.
You kidding?
It looks Burna Boyish.
What do you mean Burna Boy?
I don't even know what that is.
If you put Burna Boy in Future, yeah. And for people that actually don't even know Future, they don't think, yeah. As much as I'm going to the US, right? Because they say, you know, most of the white people can't identify, they can't differentiate between black people. They're just, yeah, Future. It'll be the same. He's got the tats, he's got the dreads, he's got the look.
Of, yeah, but he's got the look of an artist.
No, he's got the look of an American artist. I look at Tuba by him.
Okay, now you're talking about something else.
I'm not.
Well, you are, because essentially what you're saying is, if you dress a certain way and you look of a certain course. Way, it's an American way of dressing.
Of course.
But what's the American way of dressing? Because even Americans don't know the American way of dressing.
What I mean? Like,
they just dress the way they
no,
want.
No, like, you look at, look, there's, it's like.
There's
it's look, like footballers now. Like footballers got a sleeve now. I don't know why, where it came from, but there are a lot of footballers got a sleeve thing.
Yeah,
like you know, like the tattooed arm sleeve thing. You know, the same
what
way
you mean they wear clothes that have long sleeves or they
no
they have
I'm
tattoo.
Talking about the tattoos. Like
yeah,
one
it's
arm
fashion.
Tattoo.
It wasn't fashion,
of course. Whatever it is, whatever.
Yeah,
they should do that. Now, if I went to like what's that thing called, tennis, right? Long tennis, and then all of a sudden, tennis stars start having the tattoos on the.
Listen,
it'll be a little bit different.
No, you're taking it too far. The point is, like, as an artist, all right?
Yeah.
Burna Boy is flexing and enjoying himself. I don't see what's wrong with it.
Nobody said anything is wrong with it.
You sound like something is wrong with it.
I'm saying I don't
like
it.
When you look at him, you see him as an American
yeah,
artist.
Yeah, I don't, look.
The guy is an artist, okay?
No.
As an artist.
Okay, he can call himself an artist. If that's
he is an artist.
No, but it's what he identified himself as, is what I'm talking about. If he came out
he's
and
he's an Afrobeat artist. It's an Afrobeat.
He doesn't
artist.
Look like an Afrobeat artist.
What does an Afrobeat artist look
I just
like?
Just told you.
Because I can guarantee you this. Everybody that knows Afrobeat don't look like they're African himself either. I guarantee you that. What? You want to tell me Whiskey look African? It comes from... Don't talk about Two-Face, all right? Two-Face come from an era
I'm
where when they were making music, they weren't even making any money. Like, Two-Face, ignore him. All right.
Look. If I give you P-Square.
I'll give you
even Rude Boy from P-Square, right?
Doesn't dress like he's an Afrobeat artist. I can guarantee you that.
Have you seen any of his videos?
Yeah. The guy looks like he has money.
The video. I'm talking about
okay.
in an Afrobeat video.
Rude Boy. You think he dressed like an Afrobeat artist?
In his videos. Go play his latest song.
Davido.
You see. Davido in videos. Davido even... if you go to the
come on, that was supposed to be like that.
Wait a minute,
no, that was a cheap one out.
Wait
that was
a cheap
no,
one out.
It was supposed to, I mean, even that, the guy looked like he's from the forest.
She don't know, of course,
yeah, because it was supposed to be like that. Burna Boy has video,
my love, bro.
Okay, then you don't know Burna Boy.
To me.
You don't know Burna Boy.
Burna Boy is out here, you know, stepping on people's faces and you know, paying
videos.
People to get out of his concert. Then an Afrobeat artist, you know,
no, that's the guy,
that's a guy
big enough to understand that if you're doing nonsense. My no. concert, take your money back and get out.
No, that's a guy that thinks he's a certain type of an artist. That's not a true reflection of what an Afrobeat artist is. But anyway,
what's a true reflection of an Afrobeat
artist? I just told you.
Which is what?
Two-Face.
So that's not a reflection of what an Afrobeat artist is.
And that's why.
Okay, what? Okay,
that's
okay,
why
what
I find I'm offended
represent?
When Burna Boy comes out and
no,
then goes out
okay.
to be like, I'm the best since Fela Kuti. I'm like, nah, get it out of here.
You just don't like the statement, though. You just don't like this thing.
Because it's not true. Because it's not true.
Is
it's
not though?
It's not.
Is it not though?
What I just told it you it's not. True? Because it's not the best. It's not.
Who is the best? Who is?
This is how bad it is. I even think, you know, the guy that can't even talk, a.k.a. Mr. Davido, is better than him. Davido has done more. Davido does more. As when Afrobeats comes on, Davido
if you analyze what music is,
Afrobeat. Let's not go do what music is. We'll start from there.
If you analyze what music is,
yeah.
which is feelings
mm-hmm.
and rhythm on beats and however you want to do it, you make sure you can affect people through your music, right? That's
yeah.
what music is. Like, mm-hmm. you know, singing on song and affecting people,
mm-hmm.
whatever means that is,
yeah.
through your music. That's what makes you an artist, mm. right? That's what makes you talented. And then you go to Afrobeat, and then you go, yeah. okay, what's an Afrobeat artist? Then you realize that the names you mentioned, Davido. Davido only has one way he affects people through his music. It's about singing about women.
Doesn't matter if you affect them through one way.
It does and it doesn't. It does because you're only known to do one thing, right?
Doesn't matter.
Then you're not creative enough.
When you're not
that's
creative
your
enough.
Go-to thing. That's it. You just. By the way, Davido probably don't even write his own music. Most of, all of it. He doesn't even write all of it.
No, or that, do you think you know Burna Boy is writing all his music?
I don't know that. I can't really say it, but I know that Davido don't. I don't know.
Yeah, but why bring but it up?
I bring it up for this. I'm sure Davido is getting approached to sing other kind of songs with other music, but I'm sure he's choosing to refuse those kind of stuff because that's not his brand. Okay, when you look at Wizkid, it's the same. Wizkid is about the fact that he sings music for his fans. I mean, Ojuelegba was distinctly different. That's why it was big, okay? Him doing One Chance with Drake, that was also different. That was big. Other than that, there's really not that much to what Wizkid does in terms of his music. That's why his music nowadays don't sound the same. But when you pick a guy like Burna Boy,
yeah,
it gives you a different variation of himself every time it goes into the studio. Like, you really don't know. You just know a Burna Boy sound, but you kind of affiliate him to one type of music. Or one type of way of doing Afrobeat. So when you do that as an artist, mm-hmm. and when you come around and you say you complete, and then we look at all the people around you.
You say it's complete.
That's why I call myself the best. I'm the best Afro with that. Because literally saying, look, well, I don't know if you're saying that, but I can say it for him. Like, I can do all kind of variation of music in Afrobeat and still make a hit out of it. It's done that. Davido, I haven't been able to do that. Oh, he hasn't even done it to see.
You have to say he hasn't done it. That doesn't mean he can't do something. You haven't done it.
Yeah. Okay? You haven't done it, so therefore, but those you don't know how to do it.
No. You see, that's where it becomes problematic. You can't say, it's like me going, you know.
You haven't done it.
The fact that, you know.
You haven't done it. So as far as I'm concerned, till date, you don't know how to do it. Do it, then we tell you. Oh, cool! He knows how to do
but,
it.
But if
till
that's not,
date,
but
you,
but,
you
no,
don't
but
know
if
how
that's
to
not
do
part
it.
Of the game.
No. It is.
It's not.
No, it is. It's just not part of your brand. It is. It's part of the game because why? Two Baba that you've been mentioning, mm-hmm. Two-Face.
Yeah.
Two-Face give you different variation of music. I mean, and because when it does, they hit. They're not even like a song that's part of the album. They hit. Two-Face can give you a song that is literally about love and you will love it. It will give you a song that's literally about life. You will love it. It will give you a song that's literally about hardship of life. You will love it. Two-Face is the kind of guy that's talented. Wande Coal is also another guy that can do that.
I'm not.
I'm telling you why the statement that Burna Boy made and could not be that bad. It could be true.
I mean, it could not be that bad. It's a terrible thing.
Apart from him, who is?
Hmm?
Apart from him, who is? Tell me, who is? Who is in Afrobeat today that can claim that too?
Two Baba can claim that.
Get him out of the picture, bro.
Like, what do you mean, get him out of the picture?
Old school. Like, Two Baba is a legend.
Is he dead?
He's a legend.
Is he still making music? He just dropped one yesterday.
But he doesn't really. It's not in the scene like these guys are. He just comes in and out. Like, that's what he does nowadays. Because he knows this is a young man's game now. But I can still do it every now and then. So he comes in and out. But no. I'm talking about the people that are constantly doing.
Burna
Boy, Davido, Whiskey. Sarkodia.
You're not getting the point.
What's his name again?
Hold on. You're not getting. I'm not even going to say anything. What he's doing here, he didn't say, oh, after, let's say, Fela, Two Baba, blah, 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 and then currently I am.
What artist would say that? No, honestly. Do you think every artist out here saying, I'm number two to that person? Do you think any artist would say that? Every artist thinks they're the best. No.
You can give props to them.
Davido might not come out and say it. Whiskey might not come out and say it, but I'm telling you, they believe in their own heart of heart. What is the best that's ever done? In their own heart of heart.
Well, then you deluded.
That's the very definition of an artist.
No.
You believe
that
what you do, no one else can do it.
No, then you're an idiot.
Why would you be an idiot?
Because that is being overconfident. You can say that, you know, within my corner, I'm even one of the best. But not to say I am the best when you know for a definite that there are people out here doing it better than you, then you just be an idiot. Because then you're not even humble enough to go learn. How do you know for
definite that people are doing it better than you?
Because the evidence, you know.
How could you admit that?
The evidence means
you're not good enough.
No. That's what I'm saying. The fact that somebody...
It means you're saying that. And no. It means you're saying you're not good enough.
No. You see, that's what I'm saying. It's not about whether being good at... Like, let me put it this way, right? Premiership. Again, I'm going to use a football analogy. Liverpool currently, okay.
A lot of people are not been watching football. So if you use football analogy, you need to break it down. So if people listen to us, there might be females listening to this and be like, football? Seriously, I don't do that. like you need to break it down in a way where people can understand what you're trying to say.
All right, like, let me put it this way then. If you're a female listening to this, I'll use a football analogy. I'll break it into a female version and then they can maybe hear it. Football, Liverpool currently in the Premiership, dominating, right. No team is even close to them. Even the Man City team that got 100 points, you know. Best right now. Now, if Liverpool turns around, that Liverpool team now, right? They turn around and then they go, since the 92 Man United team that won the Premiership, they're the best Premiership team ever. People are going to go, are you mad?
Yeah, people could have that reaction, but they could be wrong for saying that.
But that's...
Liverpool will not be wrong for saying that.
They will. Because the other teams that have shown, but if the players went, okay, for this season, we are the best. It's fine.
No, but you're not getting the point. Listen. At what you do, which is your craft,
yeah,
you should do it because you want to be the best at it.
Keyword.
Because you want to be the best. Yeah, because you want to be the best at it. At some point, you would have to know. You hugely at the top right now.
Yes.
Okay. So if you know that as yourself in this craft, what is wrong with you saying I'm the best ever?
The ever that you added to it. That's what I'm saying. It's like the Liverpool team going, we are the best Premiership team ever. Everybody's going to, are you crazy? Do you know how many better teams you've seen?
You can say
no, because it shows your ignorance of the game that you think.
No.
It shows your ignorance of the game that you know.
It didn't show any ignorance. Of course. He said, apart from Fela Kuti, which means he's fully aware of whatever he's saying.
You want to know why he probably said that? Yeah? Because he's got Fela around his neck. It's like, what can I even think of? Who is the, like, somebody that invented something, right? Like, in Ghana.
I don't think the guy's wrong for saying what he said.
In Ghana, Hip Life was invented by Reg Rockstone. Say you're better than Rockstone automatically probably makes everybody turn off you. But if he said, apart from Rockstone, I'm better than everybody, then at least it gives you some clout.
That's wrong. I think there's some careers, like music, football, there's some careers, maybe even acting. There's some careers where you would have to say you're the best. You just
even if you're not.
Or them. But I'm saying to you,
because he's not the best saying sinner fella.
Okay, first of all, let's address Afrobeat for a second. Afrobeat in its entirety is the biggest ever it's ever been. Okay, it's getting bigger. It's getting bigger, but in terms of where we're from and where we are now, we are reaching a lot more demographic. In terms of outside Africa itself, than we've ever done. Like, guys are getting played now. Mm. I mean, Davido just got his song played during a basketball game in America, in the NBA.
But sadly, so, like, before you move on, like, and I know you move on, and I hope this doesn't, you know, make us digress from whatever we're talking about. Sadly, my opinion, this is where personal opinions come in. I think this is the shittiest, you know, time for the actual songs. For the song that actually come out of Afrobeat.
I don't understand what you're saying. What do you mean? Like,
finish your point and I'll bring it back.
There's no substance in what the songs are? Is that what you mean?
The songs are more shit. None of the songs are good.
We'll get back to that.
Yeah, that's what I said.
We'll get back to that. Cause you better go into an area where I'm gonna attack you on that too. But we'll get back to that. But my point to that is, like, because of that, because now we are the best level Afrobeat has ever reached. And
in terms of exposure.
Content. But there are people pushing that though.
Yeah.
And if you look at people pushing that, there's not a lot of people that are doing it in Afrobeat right now, pushing that boundary.
Are you talking about international?
I'm not totally talking about international. I'm talking about in every state of it. internationally, locally, nationally, whatever you want to say, Afrobeat is reaching hooks and corners of different areas now.
Yeah.
And the people pushing that.
Yeah.
The artists in this genre that are pushing that.
Yeah.
You can mention the names. Burna Boy, okay. Wizkid,
mm-hmm.
Davido,
mm-hmm.
maybe P-Square.
What do you mean maybe?
Maybe P-Square. And I don't know why I said maybe, because they pushed it and they left and then now the other boy. It's like you shoot a hoop like a basketball thing and then you pass it to somebody else. Like they're passing it now, they're like, we the grandfathers, we did this. So like, I'm gonna, like Two-Face. Two-Face, mm-hmm. I mean, these people are standing on the shoulders of other people. Two-Face is one of them. P-Square is one of them. P-Square are grandfathers now. They're kind of, you might be doing songs now, but there was a time where you dominated. Mm-hmm. And these people looked at you and go, I could do that. And you birthed these people. You birthed Wizkid. You birthed Davido. You birthed Burna Boy. Mm-hmm. Komi Eugene. Sarkodia. I forgot the name last time, but I forgot.
I'm so, you know.
What's the name again?
Yeah, Rude Boy.
Stoneboy. Stoneboy.
No, Stoneboy is not even an Afrobeat artist.
No, forget. Like, it's not even about being an Afrobeat. It's just that the fact that, well, technically it's not, but technically also is, because Afrobeat is the genre that we all play.
He's doing dancehall.
Let's
call it Afro dancehall.
Yeah, we just place them on the Afrobeats, even though we speak the patois. So all of them together are put into that. And because of that, when you look at that for what it is, I think this guy's right for saying I'm the best ever that's ever done that. Like, because he's one of the people that are doing it differently and pushing the boundary and showing the world that it's a different kind of type of way to do Afrobeat. Rather than just, because if you hear Wizkid in that video, the subject matter is the same.
I think where we differ is the fact that you keep, you know, kind of dwelling on the subject matter, and I think it's not necessary. Look, that's why there are different artists in the genre. Like, you know, it's like even in rap, for instance, right? There'll be a conscious rapper.
The same with subject matters.
It doesn't matter. That's what I said. Like, you know, in rap, you can have conscious rappers, right? Where, you know, you have your Kendrick, you know, you can even have your J. Cole's. Right, but and you have, like mumble, you have your mumble.
No, like you and I.
So you're telling me,
Afro telling subject me, matter hold on. Across the board.
Hold on. You're telling me because, you know, what, Kendrick is not going, he's not a good rapper. Is that what you're telling me? It doesn't make him like one of the best rappers around.
No, because of that. That's why, because he's not doing that. That's why they dubbed him one of the best rapper ever.
No.
You have to understand that.
No. But you are saying because Burna Boy is out here doing double, I can go and raise this and rap normal.
It's not Burna Boy is not here doing that. It's not
I'm saying.
You have to play a couple of, like I'm saying, with Burna Boy, if you listen to this album, right, you will get different variation of stuff, creativity coming from Burna Boy. Now, if you listen to Davido, if you listen to Davido, right? Like, five of his tracks are the same. Like, it's just what it is. There might be different in terms of the way the sound is.
Yeah, but you're talking about
the same.
Yeah, but you're talking about the subject matter, and I'm trying to tell you that it doesn't really matter.
It does. Why would it not?
Because
pick Wizkid. If you have like pick Wizkid's previous album and pick his latest album, guys don't give you anything different. The beats might be different, but it's not really giving you anything different. It's not. Which is why in Afrobeat, we very lenient when it comes to subject matter. Like, we just want to dance. That's the Afrobeat way of doing things. As an audience, listen to anyways. We just want to dance.
Yeah, but it's not just about dancing. You see, this probably leads on to what I was trying to talk to you about, like the content of Afrobeat currently, right? The point is, we have, you can listen to songs that, you know, you could make a girl drop a panty to, right?
We don't have that in Afrobeat, by the way.
No,
we don't. Well, when you say drop the panties, what do you mean? Because the girls drop their pants because they see stars.
No, I'm talking about you could be in the room and you could play some tracks and then she'd be like, you know.
What tracks, please, in Afrobeat? Give me a track, please. Based on what you just said, just give me a track in Afrobeat that comes from the top of your head that flies out. Queen. Huh? Are you flipping kidding me right now? You went all the way back then.
You said give me. Oh, so now.
Okay, I'm gonna change my question.
Give me star plus, you know.
all the way back then, you know, again.
It doesn't matter.
It does.
I already told you.
Okay, let me change my question.
Hold on.
Let me change my question.
I already just told you.
No, no, no. Let me change my question. No, you hold on. Let me change my question.
You want to change your question, but I'll say something before you change your question. I already told you while we're having this conversation that I think, even though now Afrobeat is spreading now, Afrobeat is reaching different people,
yeah,
and it's getting out here and those kind of stuff, I don't think content-wise is great.
But Burna Boy,
his content ain't great either anyway.
Okay, then that's subjective. Then we can discuss that. Because I've listened to Burna Boy. I could play different type, different songs that he's got. And you can tell that the subject matters and the way he does it. That's why I like Fela. Because Fela Kuti was a guy a guy married two dogs, for example, just to prove a point. I made a song about it. Like, so when you look at Burna Boy, you will see that his subject matters are well thought of. And he put it in a song. When you listen to Teni, Teni is also another one like that you have to watch out for. As subject matter, I like well thought of, and she put it in a song. Okay, she's not just the type out here that does the easy way out type of stuff.
B-Square
is back then. Don't talk about... I already told you, the people you have to admit out of this conversation. B-Square... I told you, P-Square, Two-Face, leave them out. They're not out here releasing tracks like Whiskey, Davido, Come Eugene, Kitty. They're not out here doing that. They're coming out.
You know, listening to me. I just told you that if he had just limited his conversation to now the current system.
And that's why I told you I wanted to change my question. You said you could play a song for a girl to drop a pint nowadays in Afrobeat.
Yeah.
And I said, give me a song you want to go way back.
Of course. No, hold on. I don't even need to go all the way back.
Hold on. Now I'm changing my question.
Okay, go on.
Give me a song of recent that could happen. And when you play it, the girl goes, I love you, I'm dropping my pants. Give me a song.
See me, I no get 30 billion.
If a girl is dropping her pants for you based on that song, don't marry
it's not, no, it's not about material. I'm telling you, I ain't got the money.
What
I got so much love for you.
What did Davido say on the song?
That was the remix.
It doesn't matter. The song has three verses.
Even the remix that you talk, trying to bring Davido into it, it has three verses.
Which one is the most famous one?
What do you mean you're trying to film it?
Which?
Probably the first one.
No, the remixes. You see anybody out here listening to Kitty's original song?
Yes!
Nah. It's maybe Ghanaians, huh?
If you go to YouTube, the original probably have
more views
than, you know, the remix.
I would do that right now. Because right now, you say something you should really be saying. I'll be surprised if it is. I'll be surprised. I don't think it is. Kitty.
Yeah.
All right? 30 billion. That's exactly what you do. 30 billion. Oh my god. Okay. You're right. Damn.
look. Most girls, right?
Okay, so the original, the original one is 9 million.
Yeah.
The remix one is 5.2 million.
There we go. Look, everybody, like, nothing. Most girls, right? Love the idea of love. So much love to give. If she ain't dropping the party, that's when you know she ain't a good girl to marry.
Fine, give me another one. Because that one is definitely, you know, like, yeah, okay, cool. Out of how many songs, though? Like,
what do you mean, how many songs? Go to Kwame Eugene. Yeah.
Bro, that's, you know what? This is a classic. I'm going to play again. See the difference between the Nigerians and Ghanaians? This guy's confessing that I don't have 30 billion. The video comes in here and say, I do have 30 billion. I bless the day I find you. How can this skinny guy say he don't have 30
billion? Well, he just started, he's a young kid anyway.
Of course you don't have 30 billion.
And then Kwame Eugene Confusion.
I don't even know that to start with.
You know the song. No, you just don't know that's the song's title.
Let's go to Kwame Eugene. Kwame Eugene, eh?
Yeah.
30 what?
No, so Confusion.
It's there. YouTube already brought it out. Eh? Let's see what the song is saying.
Mm-hmm.
So what are you saying? Like, Ghanaians are making more songs like this than the Nigerians are? I refuse to believe that.
Now play me Davido if. You can't say that. You're talking about punching.
You can't say that.
You can't do that though,
because even I know, like, you can't do that. But I'm saying, my I don't have any songs though.
Would you let it play?
I'm just saying though, yeah, you can't. At least that's Nigerian. Like, I'll play that.
Well, you said, you know, and so I'm saying, like, you know.
Yeah, but it's still all about love though. It's still about girls and stuff. But yeah.
My money,
the,
my body.
The song is so big that it hit 101 million views. God! Nigerians have gone far.
Forget them.
Hey!
If I tell you, say I love you.
If what else do you want? My money? Anytime they're gonna go drop.
Now, there's something. There's something that's going on here.
The last one. Play Shatawale Bulletproof.
But come on, like, that's not really a love song though, is it?
Have you heard the lyrics?
That's not a love song.
Do you know what the song is about?
The guy was screaming on the song though.
Play the flipping song.
I'm playing it, but I'm just saying that's not a love song though.
Because you haven't paid attention to the lyrics.
Bulletproof.
Shatawale.
I'm just saying, like,
how long is it taking?
Oh, I'm just, you know, Shatawale. He's like, I'm playing it, relax. I'm playing it now. Like, it's cool.
And then that's when YouTube probably pulls an advert to it. Yes. Yeah.
First of all, I don't understand what he's saying.
Stop complaining.
Baby, stop complaining.
You can't take this. This is not like Eve. No. And the other one we just played. This is not like
guy. Or push it a little bit to the chorus anyway. Yeah, yeah, leave it there.
Nah, this don't stop.
Hold on.
I'm sorry. I know Shatawale is a big artist, but nah, this is not on that level.
He's
a good song.
Bullet for you.
No. Stop it. Now you're just talking about the lyrics. Look, when we played Eve just now,
I go take bullet for you.
It was like
you.
When you play.
No, piano, the guy is saying he's going to take a bullet for you. Not one, this not two, one, not
is,
three.
This is
and you're telling me
we
that's not,
say,
you know.
I thought we were going to say this. But
Trump Keys.
No, I would say it. I'll play it. I thought you were going to say this. Because this one, classic. This is Davido 4.
Yeah, but that's not. Yeah, I thought you were talking about Shatawale.
No,
yeah.
Shatawale don't have love songs like that.
He doesn't.
No, it doesn't.
Trump Keys.
Nah. Yeah. This one. Now, this is the one where. Actually, you know what? I tell a lie. You know what? This one can drop panties. This song, this Davido song here, this will drop panties. I'm telling you, like. Because the way he did this.
See, that's a material girl. Looking at that.
No, Paraji, fall on you.
Look at one, Dad. Unless they're material
this
girl.
This one would drop panties. I'm telling you.
I eat and talk.
You know, this one is like when you're having an argument with your girl. You know what I mean?
I eat and talk.
And then you don't want to talk. You just play that video. You're like, that video, talk to half of me. No, but this okay, but it's not like out of having songs though.
I was out of having songs though. And now play, you know, Pisco Bankalet.
No. I play Pisco. Oh, no, but I you are something else.
You say Nigerians don't play. Nigerians are not dropping. Fight to drop it.
I think you planned this. Seriously, I think you planned this one. I think you put me in the corner. I think you planned this one. But I'll play it.
I'll do two attacks if you did two bad.
I'll play back a lot. Don't worry. You are such an idiot. I think this one was planned. You put me in the corner, and now I can't do anything but eat my words. The beginning of this
video, of course.
Like, oh yes, too long. See, it's abroad.
Don't worry.
See, it's abroad.
I wanna play again. And you know what? That is so real because that's exactly what happened with people that are in the relationship.
Of course.
And they tell the girl like, I'm gonna go make it.
You know how many people are out here, you know, impregnating white girls, white girl partner.
And that's before you even come. I'm gonna go make it. And the girl was like, listen, I can't wait for you. Like, you have to wait. You know, like, 1 year is too long. Nah. 1 year. See, he's abroad. People are still waiting like 5 years now. No, they got the video right though. They got a video, right? Because
look, one thing,
the back collide, like, you have to give it to P Square. That's what I'm saying.
One thing you cannot, you know, take away from P Square. Video is on point.
No, but you can't.
Choreography is on point. I don't think you can take anything away from P Square. Storyline is on point.
Even them on stage, they tried to do this for a few instances. I don't think you can take anything away from P Square.
They came to London here, and they put on a show.
No, I really don't think you take anything away from P Square. But I'm saying to you, they're not part of this generation.
Guy, just play me my bank card.
Yeah, I'm just saying, like, you're not part of this generation. Though.
And push it up before then. Right?
Hey! Yeah. All right. See, that's the thing. The guy said 1 year, and in the video they show 5 years.
I just told you that people are waiting 5 years. Of course, you can't tell 5 years.
So the girl was like, 1 year is too long, and then 5 years later, my guy. So she had to wait 4 more years.
Of course.
Oh my God.
Even Jesus said we should wait. How many years are we waiting?
Hey,
go tell your mama.
Oh God, this is an African song.
Nice, who Afrobeat is.
This is the one where you play when you go to go pay the bad price. You just play the song. You put on a boombox. Carry it with you, like, yeah, I have arrived. Tell your mama.
Nah, you need a guy with that, you know.
I know. You put in the boombox and play the drum behind you. No. See, we're creative, but we don't do it.
Wait a minute, we don't do it.
This one is definitely.
Next day. Say when I go finish, you go talk saying at me.
That's the boss.
Wait, nah.
You know what is? You know what you just did there is what Africans do and nobody. Do you know who I am? That's what you just did there. When I finish, you know it's me.
By the time I'm finished with you, by the time I'm done with you,
I already know it's you, right?
No, you don't know. When I finish with you, then.
Oh my God. Hell, boy. To prove my love, you
must chop my money. No, hold on. This is the same guy. This is the same guy that had a song that said, you must.
Yeah, but the guy just following his trend. It's cool.
Yeah, of course.
It's consistent. It's cool. Like, chop my money, you must.
Even if you like it or not.
Nah, this is dope. This is dope. But this is a hit. The subject matter is dope, and it's real. It's a classic. It's a classic. Look. And then when you play this,
P Square is one of the few artists, that you can listen to. And like,
when you play this is where you know it. Yeah, this is. This is a classic.
How many weddings have this song been played at?
This is a classic. Like, this one is the one where if you just want to talk to her and you feel nervous and you don't know how to say anything, just play this. The lyrics. Oh my God, like.
Look. P Square is too dope, man.
On the plus side, P Square is too dope, man. You don't want P Square to be next to your girlfriend. Any one of them.
Yeah, only one of them. You can't have both at the same time.
No, any one of them.
No. I think when they're combined, and that's when it's dope, more dope.
But then also, I like this Banky Dope song. This one's also
what? Is it yes?
Yeah.
Yes or no?
Yeah, yes. This is. But this one is the only classic.
But this is way older.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, but you can't call him like one of those guys because he just pops in and out. He's more like a business guy.
And he's acting as well, anyway.
Nah, but this is a dope. Like,
of course.
Yeah, but I don't know how many songs.
Like, wait, I don't know how many songs.
We have like 1,000 songs and they only have 20 songs that's about.
Look at this guy hating it.
That's about the kind of substance that we're talking about. People, man, I think we are feeling ourselves too much. But going back to our point, Burna Boy being like, all this stuff's dope. and they're really great. And yeah, you did make me eat my words a bit. Not entirely.
You choked on them.
Not entirely. You choked on them. Because you only played like, oh, Kitty, the Odu was done when? Done like 3 years ago?
Maybe 2-3 years ago.
2-3 years ago. Davido,
if.
But
look, a point that look, just stop hating.
You know? Davido killed it with if though. Like, I'm not even gonna
look. Trust
like,
me,
if like if, and if, the four. What I'm saying, he killed it.
You could stack up all these songs.
But
Whiskey,
we don't have any song like that for Whiskey. No, which is the bad thing. This is the really bad. Like,
we do, what but it's not as hip. It's not,
which one?
Even the one with him.
So Davido is better than Whiskey.
The fact that we can't remember it doesn't.
No,
mean,
which one? Which one? Let's look. Which one?
Even the song with the song that had what's her name. Yemi in the no what's that Tiwa in there that was you know
Tiwa Savage
yeah
oh the one where she was kissing him she was molesting the guy
wait
which one what's the name of the song
Fever
no but this is not no you didn't there's nothing in this song. Wait, it's that boy there for you that's all there's nothing in the song that's all you, that's not what we played over like. That's what we said in this song over like a million times. There was nothing in this song. Stop my day for you. Baby girl, you find yourself though. Your boy is this. I'm sorry.
Wait, hey!
This does not qualify. I'm sorry, you're talking about if. You're talking about Odu. You're talking about no one like you and you want to play this in that. Nah, I'm sorry.
Well, then you're going to play, you know. Then you have to go way back then. And if you
Which one is way back? Give me something.
Me drive by.
Even this one is better. Like, give me something. Because even Tiwa Savage and Corey the Banks, what's his name again? Even Tiwa Savage and him. Why am I playing this? Oh, YouTube telling me I have to play Whiskey though. YouTube is literally them or mad over you. This one is a classic though. And this guy included Ghana in there.